are more than suitable replacements for Lifestealer and Earthshaker.
Well, Alco actually do something on like the Lifestealer if you want to run Straft, and he's a great early mech builder for the team. He can just get a BKB and start the fights.
Yeah.
He also has a stun, which it felt like they didn't have enough of last game. They had this awkward decrepify. And he'll actually start denying the range, so this lane is me going against him. Oh no, oh no. This could be bad. Hiding near the ramp, he does walk it down into the river, and then Colts will come through. The clap falls up. Spurt has a stun. He will get off, but Banana already off to a power. Well, let's see if they can catch up here. They'll start with a nice vortex, then they'll go through with the Pugna slow, the decrepify, then a burrow straight comes in, and Chao 8, if he gets caught, will go down here. Indeed he will, so two cores being shut down for Veech. It's gotta be FY turns this game around in the mid game, and that's not gonna help when he gets blown up by... There was a Radiant Observer Ward that saw this,
and
there's nobody here either. He's soaked. He's so really screwed. Disruption comes through, Sunstrike as well, but it actually doesn't do quite that much damage. He drops the stun, the amps, well, that'll be enough to secure the kill. Then FY comes in, he wants to kill off this Shadow Demon, and he will find the kill. That gets him a much needed level 5.5. And a blink. Pretty close. Meanwhile, Blink. I'll switch the melee. He's got hope available. He's jumping towards you.
He's under attack.
Want to do it. He's committing this fight. He's gonna... Oh no, he's alive for now, actually. Super. Dropping the Acid Spray. Fenrir's here as well. Where's that Sand Cane? You can't find a good angle in without the ultimate. And now the courier casually comes through. How? Just ignoring it. It's all bait, so like, we're hoping that'll go for him. But not so lucky. Gives him the life drain. The burst streak immediately dark packed. That will allow Hao to make his way out of this one. If the timing was just a little bit different, I think they'd get that kill.
And Fenrir is kind of left out the drive.
I love
too.
This courier just like making drive-bys
over
nice the fight.
Oh, nice from Fenrir.
Point blank on Slark. Well, I'm busy talking about the courier. Get the kill. Fenrir will fall as an... I think he'll still come out on top in those engages.
Wow, even Banana has a scepter. What in the world? 22 minutes.
Now FY gets caught out top lane. He will start dropping this arc pack. There's a burrow into the trees, but the Sunstrike's gonna find him! Ooh, another sensational Sunstrike!
And we'll come out and Ice Blast.
Only gonna connect on how, and well, with that, it might force him back, but Invoke happy to muscle down the Roshan. FY will blink in. He goes for the Aegis Snipe. He's gonna get Sunstrike though, and Hao comes in now with the gem. He thought he could steal the Aegis. Unfortunately, he does snatch it right as the Rosh goes off. They could have killed him first, then gone for the Aegis, but instead they give it away. And they'll sound the retreat. While this is going on, Slark is pushing top. He leads way to safety, but the chase is on, and in comes the Apis from FY. He's now two. Mu manages the BKB just in the nick of time. Just the Alk stun, the stun effect, but super now. Chase back, the imps start coming in. The BKB is gonna wear off in a few seconds. They don't even need this imp damage. One imp will do him in, and the BKB ends at just the wrong moment. He's almost dead. He does live for now. Sand King being pursued out all the way to the base. Fenrir will be as well. They'll lose the ancient apparition there. They've used the epicenter. They use the AA ult. But a great three hero deafening blast will halt this aggression for now. They're looking for some life drain. Once Arles give him the suck once again. Banana stunned up, dropping pretty fast, and will fall, I believe, to another burrow strike. They can call up this enchantress. They will do so. Though Hao is still at full HP and doing quite a bit of work on the backside of the fight. And it looks like he can go back in. He's got a blink available. Kills off a ward. It did run out of most of his mana. Now leaped in again on Psylocke, who has it to Krefi. He'll use it defensively to try and buy him a bit of time. But Hao just pause BKB, continues to stand strong against it. And Super, unable to fully kill him off. Does he have a stun available? Nothing doing yet. Another Sand King stun. FY really doing his job this way. It's just not enough. They've lost the Sand King. If he doesn't have buyback, I feel they're out of damage. They do bring down the Shadow Demon. Work on Hao here. He got bashed Super to buy the Basher earlier. And it might be enough for the kill. Do they have their Alk stun? Still not ready. How's it? There's a buff popped, and looks like Newbie are going to commit. Epicenter's available. Is it being channeled now by FY? Oh, he's thinking about it. Roche is dropping low. Is he going to go in or not? He goes in again. The clockwork snatches the Aegis. FY's there with the double. Oh, though he will be with his life. Once again, Vici finding a way to keep themselves in this game, though they lost two for that, and they might lose super as well. There's a not even a bash needed, I think. Goes down. He says, screw it. We're going in anyway. There is still an Epicenter online that was not used to snatch the Aegis. And, we'll have a team fight recap. But yeah, the fight's gonna break out now. Super gets caught by Deafening Blast, and leaping in is Hao. He commits to the Alk. He finds the kill. The Alk is gonna be able to buy back in this fight. He doesn't actually have it. It's on cooldown for 6 minutes. He already bought back once, and he's out of the engagement. Meanwhile, FY's gonna drop pretty quickly. ROTK gets clubbed down by Xiao 8. And they're gonna look to commit to the high ground here. Four here dead. RLTK, this could be a dieback for him potentially as well. He's not going to go down just yet. He'll GG out. Won't even bother buying back. And with that being said, VG Gaming just get run over. They're now 0-2. DK and Newbie both 1-0 after the first two games of WPC Group B play.
I think VG's versatility has always been the weakness. And it's really showcased in the past two matches where they go to what they like to run, but it's just not effective versus the opponent's drafts and not terribly well executed, surprisingly.